இளம் தென்னல் மூழுன்ன கானம், இளவை போல் உள்ள ஸ்நேகம், கினாக்கள் கடும் தன்ன லோகம்,
மலத்தின் ஓரோ முட்டும் ஓரோ ஸ்வப்னம், அவையில் காணாராகும் நீதோரோ மோகமோரோ வர்ணம், ஆராரோ பாடுவதாது நீஹாரார்த்ததாகும் அறியாமோ பிராக்களே.
Our saint leader and ingenious David Vincent of 11A will shortly be on stage to greet each and everyone present here today.
Good morning, everyone. On this special day of our dear friends, in the presence of Almighty, firstly, I would like to welcome our manager, Reverend Father Anthony H. Rosefeld, whose unwavering dedication and visionary guidance have paved the way for countless achievements and success. We welcome you, Father. Next, I would like to welcome our manager, our principal, Reverend Father Paul Animodin, whose dedication, mission and commitment to the school has inspired us to reach for this class. We welcome you, Father. Now, I would like to welcome our PTA Vice President, Sandhya Pramod Ma'am, whose energy has navigated our school to success. Welcome, ma'am. I would like to also welcome Brother Anil for his presence up here. Welcome, sir. Welcome, Father. Next, I would like to welcome the stars of the day, dear friends of class 10th and 12th, to this celebration. Last but not least, I would like to welcome our teachers, non-teaching staffs, and all my dear fellow friends for this auspicious and memorable ceremony. If at all I have missed to welcome anyone who missed my name, I would like to welcome him or her, also for this day's celebration. Thank you.
Thank you, David.
As you journey on. So I am proud and happy because am going to journey along with you. May not be in the physical sense, but in spirit and truth. I will be enjoying every moment of your success. I will be thanking God for every step that you are taking for the future. That's why today I stand here with a very proud and a happy heart. A very beautiful title is given, a royal alvida to our luminaries. Very thought-provoking, very powerful. A royal alvida. Very kingly goodbye. This goodbye is not an end, but a beginning of another journey. This goodbye is not a conclusion to a chapter. It is the beginning, the next page of your book of life. And that's why I hope Father Principal will give me some time. I need some time to talk with you. Just give something for your life. And that's why I told in the beginning, give me proper attention and proper listening. I'm going to talk to you as a motivator for you, an inspiration for you. So I have written something, penned down something for you. The first thing which I want to tell you is, be a winner. And that's the topic. Be a winner. Can you say it loud? Be a
winner.
And say, I am a winner. Okay, and that's the way we begin our journey. We are winners. What are the features of a winner? He should have a bald head, he should have a broad smile, and he should have a big stomach. That's the feature of a winner. Am I correct? No, features are no problem. Even if you have no hair in the head, if you have a big stomach, even if you don't have a smile or broad smile, we can be a winner. How you can be a winner? Winner doesn't mean one who comes first. The winner is the one who can say, I have served this planet and I have contributed something to this planet and I have a journey in this planet. So winning is not equated with coming first in the places. Winning is connected with what you are going to be, what you are. So I just want to give you some tips for this winning attitude in your life. Listen patiently. What are the winning attitude? The most deadly addiction for a winner. What is the most deadly addiction for a winner? Addiction to distraction is the end of your creative production. Addicted to distractions. My dear boys and girls, the future stars of this planet, what can distract you, what can derail your journey in this life is the distractions that you may carry along with your life. A winner cannot be distracted in his life. He has to be well focused. What are the little distractions that we carry? Maybe your addiction to the use of media. Maybe the mobile. There can be addiction to your laziness. Your addiction to procrastination, keeping the things for tomorrow. There can be addiction to your always saying, I can't. Not believe in yourself. Let what may be, I am like this. I cannot change. So there are these definite distractions in your life. Keep away from distraction. You identify that distraction that defocuses you from your life journey. A winner cannot be distracted. A runner in the race, if he has to achieve the goal, he cannot be distracted by the audience, the clappings, the appreciation. He focuses on to the finishing point. So my dear, let us not get into little distractions. You know, if you, I don't want to say it very publicly, what are the distractions? You can be infatuated with for one another. You can fall in love with one another. Let that not be a cause of distraction. You can be distracted in many entertainment programs. You can be distracted with the drugs, alcohol. There are so many things with which you can get addicted and distracted. To my dear future stars of this planet, I want to advise you, be careful about the distraction, addiction to the distraction. We all can have distraction, but the addiction to this distraction. As we move out from this alma mater of yours, be sure that I will focus in my life, I will have an aim in my life. I will not give my life event into the distractions in my life. So there will be no addiction to distractions in your life. Second point, you are here in this planet for a reason. Believe in that particular statement. You are here in this universe, in this planet for a reason. Nobody can be without any reason. Think about it. That is the purpose of your life. There is a reason for my living. There's a reason for my living. We are all here for some special reason. Stop being a prisoner of your past. Become an architect of your future. Not become a prisoner of the past. Prisoner of your the unsuccessful events, but believe I am here with a purpose, I am here with a reason, and that should be the motivating spirit wherever you are, whatever you are going to be. I am here with a purpose, I am here with a reason, and that will enable you to be out of your distraction. Third point, see with the vision of an achiever. See with the vision of an achiever. Where the victims see adversity, extreme achievers see opportunities. See with the vision of an achiever. Vision, the perspective that we should have. We should have the perspective not of a defeated person, but of a person who believes that everything in my life is an opportunity. Everything, every person whom I meet, every event that I encounter in my life is an opportunity for me. The success belongs to those people who can grab at the opportunities that is given to you. Keep your eyes open. Keep your all senses open. The opportunities will knock at your door. And everything is an opportunity. Even your failure is an opportunity for you for success. Believe that everything is an opportunity. So my dear girls and boys, believe that God brings people into my life. God brings events into my life. All these are opportunities for me in my life. I can speak more about it. Fourthly, success is about result. Less talk, more to do. No one cares about your elegantly expressed intentions, only your brilliantly executed result. Be sure in life, like me standing here, can talk great, great things. But what you will be noticing, the result of what I do. So that is what more important. We can speak, we can listen, but believe what result you are bringing. For example, you take your life here. You may have a student here. You are studying, you are participating in all the activities. But the result you bring will prove what you are. The success person is result oriented. So rather than speaking just like me, here and there, what you can speak. No, it should be result oriented. And the fifthly, start movements, not business. It's a great statement. Start movements, statements. Example. Take an example of a cop. And we call the needles movements. They keep on tickling and moving one point to the another. If it's a business, it gets stuck up, it becomes an establishment. Everything that you should make should not be a business. Business means you get stuck up and we will not be able to further see or grow. Rather, just like a movements, part one point to the another. So in your life, not establishing a big business, but make your life as movements, just like a goal, just click by step by step, moving, but completing that cycle of life. So make movements, not business. Then one little tips for you. Practice the psychology of, I spoke already, the psychology of possibilities. The world is open to options. Possibilities are many. And learn to be, mentor yourself to the possibilities available before you. Not create the mentality of I can't and excuses. The mentality of excuses and I can't. Two things are very clear. There are possibilities. Everything is a possibility for us. But the moment we get addicted to say, I can't. Oh, this I can't. This I can't. That I can't. That person I can't bear with. This person I can't live with. When you have only can'ts in your life, the life success will be a closed matter for you. When you give excuses for everything in your life, excuse for coming late, excuses for not anything. There are thousands and one excuses that you find in your life. As you get up from the morning till go to bed, we have a lot of excuses. Don't create that mentality of excuses in your life. Rather say, I can and I will do it. So these are the little tips to be a winner. And that is my wishes for you, my future stars of this school, that you be a winner in your life. I take this opportunity to thank you for all that you are to us, the wonderful things that you did to the school, and definitely the school will be having lots of proud moments because of you. When your name comes, when you get success, that becomes our success too. So school will be proud of you. Make this your alma mater proud pride. And that's my wish. I will be accompanying you, walking along with you in my prayers and my spirit. All my best wishes to you. Be always a winner. God bless you.
Thank you, dear Father, for inspiring, heart-touching, motivating words about Your words will touch our heart and reassure you that we follow what you said. It is time for the most blessed spiritual treasure and cherishable moment that is about to unfold before us. We will be experiencing the divine presence of Almighty God. To start with, let us all stand for prayer led by our manager. All our guests are requested to light their candles before starting the prayer.
All the students of 10th and 12th, please stand. Others just sit to listen, okay? Father Anthony is going to pray for the students of 10th and 12th. Please light your candles. This candle is a symbolic expression of that you are the light of the world, okay? So please pay attention. Don't make noise. Okay, others, so please fold your hands and sit there. Okay, all the students of 10th and 12th, please light your lamps as a symbolic way of expression. And please keep silent. Father will pray for you.
Keep your eyes closed, all of you. Keep your eyes closed, hands closed. Just fall into the moment of silence. Let the silence of this cosmos empower you. Let us believe, I am the light of the world. I am the light of the world. There is that divine light within me. I am holding that divine in my heart. With that silence, let us all together in a loud voice pray the prayer, the universal prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive our trespasses. Deliver us from evil. Amen. God, our loving Father, we thank you for the moment of our life here in this school. We have been here. We have received wisdom, knowledge. Lord, we thank you for having allowed us to be part and students of this great institution, St. Vincent Paroli School. You have been so kind to us. You have protected us from every danger. You have gathered us as the hen gathers her children around her wings. And you have protected us from every danger. You have inspired in us the wisdom of your love through our teachers. We experience the warmth of friendship. We experience the warmth of consideration and care and understanding. All it is because of you. And we know that we are here because of a reason. We know that we are here because there's a purpose in my life. I am created with a purpose in this life. Lord, now at this moment, I am turning to the another page of my life, making a new page in my life. And I want that God accompany with me. Be with me in all my endeavors, all my undertakings. Be in my mind, in my thinking, in my imaginations, in my actions. God be first for me in everything. Lord, we are weak. We are human beings. We know that we have a tendency to go away from the path that we have chosen. The way which you have shown us, the right path, the path of justice, path of love, path of consideration for the other. If you are with us, we are not afraid to move along and ahead. At this moment, Lord, guide our steps, lighten our path, so that we may remove the darkness from us and that we may live in light. But at this moment, I extend my hand and I bless every student of mine, students who are saying goodbye to this institution. Bless them, O Lord. Inspire them, O Lord. Strengthen them, O Lord. God Almighty, Father, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, God bless you and shower His blessing upon you. Amen.
Thank you, Father, and thank you, friend. Our guests are now asked to move forward, led by the little class teachers, onto the stage according to the names that we called to receive a token of love from Palatine County, which commemorates during that time we ask you and celebrate these bonds and wish our departing students good health, joy, and success wherever they will be. I request our fathers to give away the mottos to our seniors.
അപ്പോ എല്ലാവരും ആത്മാർത്ഥതയോടും ഈശ്വര വിചാരത്തോടും കൂടി പഠനം നടത്തുവാൻ എല്ലാവിധ ആശംസകളും ഞാൻ നേരുന്നു.
Beloved students of class 10 and 12 and all the other students present in this hall, please keep silence. Father Anthony has already given you a motivation talk on the tips of who is going to be a winner. I'm not taking much time. This farewell program, the students of 9 and 11 and the teachers need a lot of preparation, and we have arranged this program for you. I know that the students of 10 and 12 are very busy with the studies. Yes, all those who are talking, please quiet. And a lot of efforts is taken by the students of 9, 11 and the teachers for this day. And that is with the purpose, dear students of 10th and 12th. The purpose is that we want to tell you that you are someone, okay? We want to tell you that at this moment, we wish that you should express or show your maturity and your responsibility. All these days, the teachers and parents are telling you to study, okay? Go on studying. They are behind you, they are with you all the time. Now the time has come for you to realize that I am responsible for my life. And you are preparing for the board exam. And today onwards, you will be studying, preparing, not because others are telling. The parents are behind you, the teachers are behind you. No. You have reached certain maturity and you know that what I am doing today, this moment, I am doing with my own conviction. I want to do well in my board examination. So that, we want to tell you that you have the strength to express your maturity and your responsibility. From today onwards, and from after also, when you go ahead also, nobody will be with you. All these years, from KG onwards, teachers were with you, parents are with you, guiding you, directing you, giving you punishment and so many things. From now, you have reached an age, a time that you should direct yourself. You are responsible for you. And that's my prayer and wish for all of you. Students of 10th and 12th, you have reached a certain age and you must be doing things as per your conviction. I want to do it, not because teachers are behind me, not because the parents are behind me. So with that approach, you should go ahead with your board exam. Now, few days are there for you. the time is short, but whatever time is with you, ahead of you, please go with this approach that I am responsible for myself. I want to do well, not because others are behind me. If you have this approach, it will stop all your unwanted things. Okay? Then you will become responsible students. You will take your studies seriously. Your life you will be taking seriously. So I am not prolonging. I just want to wish all of you all the best for your board examination. And thank all of you for being part of this institution for many years. I hope, of course, the 12th standard will be going away from the institution. I want to wish all the 12th standard students, wherever you are, a happy and successful life ahead. And also the 10th standard, some of you may be here, some of you may be other students. I wish you all the best in your life. Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you for your most meditative words.
Awards encourage young scholars to perform better in academic as well as extracurricular areas. Awards for students increase a sense of pride, which can help them meet or widen their goals. One of the most awaited events has arrived. Our principal will now disclose the name of the students who have been chosen as the best for this. I hand over the mic to our principal.
Hello. We have the custom of selecting one boy and one girl from 10th as well as from 12th standard, and we call them best Palatine boy, best Palatine girl. Not others, not because others are not best, all are best. Because we select, of course all the teachers are involved in this, not only our studies, but we saw some special talents, qualities, some exemplary life in them. And we just want to appreciate them for the good model that they were in the school. Okay, not others are bad, but all are good students. Because of their examples, examinary life, so teachers have seen in them. So that's why they put there some criteria they have selected. So I'd like to announce the from class 10, the best Palatine boy is Arfaz Farid.
I request Anthony, Father Anthony, to kindly come forward to give a little.
And the best Palatine girl is Sona P. Beni. And from the 12th standard, we have the best Palatine boy, Harold Harry Skate. And best Palatine girl, Mayuka. Mayuga. So congratulations to the best Palatine boys and best Palatine girls. Tips of who is going to be a winner. I'm not taking much time. This farewell program, the students of 9 and 11 and the teachers need a lot of preparation. And we have arranged this program for you. I know that the students of 10 and 12 are very busy with the studies. Yes, all those who are talking, please quiet. And a lot of efforts is taken by the students of 9, 11 and the teachers for this day. And that is with a purpose, dear students of 10th and 12th. The purpose is that we want to tell you that you are someone, okay? We want to tell you that at this moment, we wish that you should express or show your maturity and your responsibility. All these days, the teachers and parents were telling you to study, okay? Go on studying. They are behind you, they are with you all the time. Now the time has come for you to realize that I am responsible for my life. And we are preparing for the board exam. And today onwards, you will be studying, preparing, not because others are telling. The parents are behind you, the teachers are behind you. No. You have reached certain maturity and you know that what I am doing today, this moment, I am doing with my own conviction. I want to do well in my board examination. So that, we want to tell you that you have the strength to express your maturity and your responsibility. From today onwards, and from after also, when you go ahead also, nobody will be with you. All these years, from KG onwards, teachers are with you, parents are with you, guiding you, directing you, giving you punishment and so many things. From now, you have reached an age, a time that you should direct yourself. You are responsible for you. And that's my prayer and wish for all of you. Students of 10th and 12th, you have reached a certain age and you must be doing things as per your conviction. I want to do it, not because teachers are behind me, not because the parents are behind me. So with that approach, you should go ahead with your board exam. Now few days are there for you, the time is short, but whatever time is with you, ahead of you, please go with this approach that I am responsible for myself. I want to do well, not because others are behind me. If you have this approach, it will stop all your unwanted things. Okay? Then you will become responsible students. You will take your studies seriously. Your life, you will be taking seriously. So, I am not prolonging. I just want to wish all of you all the best for your board examination. And thank all of you for being part of this institution for many years. I hope, of course, the 12th standard will be going away from the institution. I want to wish all the 12th standard students, wherever you are, a happy and successful life ahead. And also the 10th standard, some of you may be here, some of you may be other students. I wish you all the best in your life. Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you for the most words.
Awards encourage young scholars to perform better in academic as well as extracurricular areas. Awards for students engrave a sense of pride which can help them meet or widen their goals. One of the most awaited events has arrived. Our principal will now disclose the name of the students who have been chosen as the best
for this. I hand over the mic to our principal. Hello. We have the custom of selecting one boy and one girl from 10th as well as from 12th standard, and we call them best Palatine boy, best Palatine girl. Not because others are not best, all are best, because we select, of course, all the teachers are involved in this, not only our studies, but we saw some special talents, qualities, some exemplary life in them, and we just want to appreciate them for the good model that they were in the school. Okay, not others are bad, but all are good students. Because of their examples, exemplary life, so teachers have seen in them. So that's why they put their some criteria they have selected. So I'd like to announce the from class 10, the best Palatine boy is Arfaz Farid.
I request Anthony, Father Anthony, to kindly come forward to give a word.
And the best Palatine girl is Sona P. Beni. And from the 12th standard, we have the best Palatine boy, Harold Harry Skate. And best Palatine girl, Mayuga. Mayuga. So congratulations to the best Palatine boys and best Palatine girls.
കുട്ടി ആദ്യമായി Thank you. stay in the big house.
Yeah.
അപ്പോ വല്ലവരാണോ? ഞാനൊരു മാത്രം പഠിച്ചിട്ടില്ല
സഹോ. ക്ലാസ്സിൽ കയറാതെ മതിലിയാളിയും മാതിരി നിന്ന് സാധനം ഉറപ്പിച്ചു നടന്നാലോ? അവസാനം പരീക്ഷ വരുമ്പോൾ ഫുൾ മാർക്ക് എടുത്ത് എല്ലാ കൂട്ടുകാരുടെ ഇടയിലുണ്ടാവും. നമ്മളെ കൂട്ടുകാരത് ആരാണോ
Thank you. Yeah.
has now come to an end. I hope you all enjoyed the astounding performance of our gifted friends. Each student performed applaudably, talently, and marvelously. Thanks to all our friends.
Each student will be having innumerable experiences in their life, which he or she would be willing to share with other inmates before they leave the school after board exams. I am Rajesh from 10B and Shreya Joji from 12C expressed their desire to share a few words of their journey, both academically and non-academically, during the days of Palloti. I request both of them to kindly come onto the stage for the same.
A very good afternoon to all, respected principal, manager father, teachers, and my dear friends. Today I stand before you with a mix of feelings and say goodbye to everything that was familiar and to everything that was comfortable. First of all, I would like to thank Almighty God with a sincere heart for giving us wonderful years we had spent over here. Next, with immense pleasure, I would like to express my gratitude to the father, Paul Animutin, and dear manager, Anthony S. Roseman, teaching and non-teaching staff, who helped us in journey of our school life. I enjoyed my school life from the day I was here till today. I got many memorable experiences with good education. I also have a lot of beautiful memories with my friends and my teachers as well. All these memories are valuable and will always be in my heart forever. My school was like my second home where I shaped my future. The other best part of my school life was the connection with all my beautiful teachers who taught me from my smaller classes till my 12th standard. All of them together made my school life the best. As we say goodbye to our school days, there might be some tears, but there will be plenty of smiles. This moment will always stay with us and will always cherish it. Thank you.
A lot of unforgettable memories, especially during Yeah. I appreciate all my friends, teachers who are there for my highs and lows. Not only the teachers and my friends, but I'm also thanking Father Polani Mutu and Father Roswan, Anthony Roswan, for taking such wonderful decisions throughout the year. I'm also thanking the school management and also my lovely IHATs. I'm really happy to have one and all of you in my life. You all have made my school life wonderful. My dear friends, this is the place where we all diverge in ourselves. This is the place where I thank all my teachers and my school management who have made one and all of our school year to be wonderful. This is a wonderful day that you have created us. Keep giving us such beautiful ways and memories that we could uphold together. This is me, Ayana Radesh. I hope I have made an unforgettable memory in yourselves. Not just a goodbye, but just a way to build a new future. Hope I stay on your memories. Thank you.
Thank you, Ayana and Shreya.
Before the curtain falls, as an indication to the elevating of the days, memorable for gathering, Aditya Nanda is requested to be on the stage for a few minutes.
Today, as we stand on the brink of a new chapter, I am filled with a mix of gratitude and a hint of nostalgia. It is an honor to stand before you, express our heartfelt appreciation and bid farewell on behalf of the 10th year graduating class. I thank our managing partner, Anthony Roswan, for always supporting us and being there for us whenever needed. To our respected principal, your leadership has been a guiding light for this institution. Your vision and commitment to excellence have set the tone for our own educational journey. Thank you for fostering an environment that encourages both academic and personal growth. I thank our respected PTA Vice President, Mrs. Sandhya Pranod, for attending this grand program. I also thank our brother Akhil for making his presence known. I express my gratitude to Mrs. Sapya Ma'am, Anita Ma'am, Jida Ma'am, and Sheila Ma'am for organizing this grand ceremony. My special thanks to my class teacher, Mrs. Priya Ma'am, for always being supportive and positive even during our hardest times. I thank the school coordinators, Mrs. Bindu Ma'am, Mrs. Jensi Awesome Ma'am, Aishwarya Ma'am, and Jensi Ma'am for keeping the school organized and disciplined. I also thank the art teachers, Mrs. Sinita Ma'am, Mrs. Soni Ma'am, and Mrs. Srikala Ma'am, and the dance teacher, Mrs. Sina Ma'am, for decorating and putting together this grand ceremony. I extend my deepest gratitude to our dedicated and inspiring teachers. Their unwavering commitment to our education has shaped us into the individuals we are today. Their guidance, encouragement, and tireless efforts have made a lasting impact on our lives. Thank you for being more than just educators. We have been mentors and pillars of support. To the school staff, present and unfortunately absent, from maintaining the facilities to organizing events, your contributions have not gone unnoticed. Thank you for making our school experience smooth and memorable. To my dear juniors, your enthusiasm and energy have added vibrancy to our school life. As we pass the creative degree, embrace the opportunities and challenges that come your way. Cherish the bonds you form and may your journey be better than ours have been. To my fellow graduates, hope the journey has been. Thank you for being companions on this incredible ride. As we step into the next chapter of our lives, let's take the spirit of camaraderie and the lessons learned within these walls. May the future hold success and happiness for each one of us. Before we part ways, I seek the blessings of our respective dignitaries and the good wishes of our juniors for the upcoming board exams. Lastly, I end this session with a quote from the late former chess player. My unmatched perspicacity, coupled with sheer indefatigability, makes me a feared opponent in any realm of human endeavor. Thank you.
optimistic, humble,